The Forbidden City. The largest palace on Earth, in the heart of Beijing. To the emperors of China, this was the center of the world. On New Year's Day, 1421, this architectural wonder was unveiled in a grand opening ceremony by the great Ming Emperor, Yongle.
It's very hard to walk through the main gate without being in utter awe of that man.
Set on 180 acres and with 9,000 rooms, the Forbidden City hailed its creator, the Emperor Yongle, as the supreme ruler of all China. He forged his great vision from timbers felled thousands of miles from Beijing, and giant slabs of marble hauled across ice. The emperor marshaled a million people to build a palace that would last a million generations.
They paid homage to His Majesty, the one true son of heaven.
But Yongle had no right to call himself emperor, no right to build a palace of his own. It was raised on the blood of others. This warlord had clawed his way to the top, fought foul, betrayed his own family, killed all in his path to steal the throne. Everything to prove that he was heaven's chosen agent on earth. But now, as the world's eyes turn to Beijing, long-forgotten chronicles from the Ming era have been translated into English for the first time. They tell how he constructed a gilded prison, stocked with exotic concubines, policed by eunuchs, and rife with greed, treachery, and danger.
Your only duty is to love me.
But this closeted world would be shaken by a murder so monstrous that it provoked the vengeance of heaven.
Has my rule gone astray?
Has my rule gone astray?
Has my rule gone astray?
This Crimson Palace, the heart of Beijing, has hidden its dark secrets for far too long.